Okay, this is Krishna. So I am zoology faculty in Alcoxia Junior College, Narsarpeta. So now we discuss about the human male reproductive system. This is the second year topic. So now we discuss about the structure and functions of human male reproductive system. So the human male reproductive system consists several organs, which is present in the pelvic region of human body. So pelvic region means below the abdomen cavity. So which organs is? Number one, testes, and another one, accessory ducts, and another one, accessory glands, and another one, external genitalia of human being. So now we discuss about the testes. So the human male reproductive system consist of a pair of testes. So these testes structure is ovoidal structure and the color is pinkish color. So these testes present in the scrotum. So the scrotum means a sac like structure. So this is called as scrotum, a pair which is present in the this structure. So each testes, so within the scrotum, so two parts which is connected to the each testis. So these part is number one inguinal canal. So number one spermatic cord. So this is the spermatic cord. And another one gubernaculum. So these two forms to hold the testis within the scrotum in same position. So now the gubernaculum present in the below the each testis, that is connected to inner wall of the scrotum, and another one spermatic cord. So the spermatic cord is present anterior part of each testis. This is formed by fusing of nerves and blood vessels, and another one blood vessels and nerves. So this is used to form the spermatic cord. So this scrotum connected to the abdominal cavity. So this cavity is called as inguinal canal. Inguinal canal. So this is the inguinal canal that is connected to abdominal cavity. So now structure of the testes. So for example, this is the testes. These testes externally enveloped by two layers. The outer layer is called tunica vaginalis, and the inner layer is called tunica albuginea. So this is two layers externally enveloped each testis. So next, so this tunica albuginea, so this is extend inwards and divided to 250 compartments means 250 lobes. So this internal layer, that is enter into the testis and divides into 250 lobes. So this is the one lobe, this is the one lobe, this is one. So this like 250 is divided by the tunica albuginea. So now, so this is one of the lobe. So if it is one of the lobe, so these lobe, each lobe of human testis contain 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules. So this seminiferous tubule internally lined by germinal epithelium. So the each seminiferous tubule consists of two types of cells. So two types of cells, one is spermatogonial mother cells. One is spermatogonial mother cells, and another one Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells. So this is two types of cell which is present in the inside of the seminiferous tubules. So now spermatogonial cells. So now discuss about the spermatogonial cells. So the spermatogonial cell is undifferentiated spermatogonial cell is which is present seminiferous tubules. So undifferentiated means so not processing cells. So means diploid cells, common body cells. So later this is converted into spermatogonial primary spermatocytes. Primary spermatocytes. So later these primary spermatocytes, after that, so do meiotic division, it is converted into the spermatozoa. Spermatozoa. So these spermatozoa, so after undergoes to sperms. So this is sperm production takes place is a seminiferous tubules of the testes. So this is the about the spermatogonial mother cells. After that, Sertoli cells. So the Sertoli cells also present in the seminiferous tubules. So the Sertoli cells function is, so this is due to two functions. Number one function is nourishment to sperms, and another one is it is produced the inhibin hormone. So inhibin hormone, and number one function is nourishment to sperms, and inhibin hormone function is induced the FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, FSH. So this is the two functions of Sertoli cells. And outer side of each lobe, so this is one lobe, this is one lobe, this is one lobe, outside of the each lobe, this space is called as interstitial space. The interstitial space contain interstitial cells. So these interstitial cells called as Leydig cells. So Leydig cells, so these Leydig cells function is, so it is induced, it is produced the androgens. So androgens function is, so it is produced secondary sexual characters of human. So it is important functions. So secondary sexual characters means male voice change and beard. So this is the secondary sexual function. So next, so each seminiferous tubule, so it is open, enter into the, so vasa efferentia. So these vasa efferentias, all vasa efferentias extend anterior part of testes, and so this is open into the vasa differentia. So through the retail testes means the network of vasa efferentia. So this is about the testes. So next topic is, so next after that, accessory ducts. So the accessory ducts, so it is involving the path of sperms. So path of sperms, so number one is retail testes and vasa efferentia. So and epididymis and vas epididymis, so later urethra, penis. So this is the path of sperms. So first we discuss about the epididymis. So this part is called as epididymis. So the definition of epididymis is, all vasa efferentia leave the testes and enter into the narrow tightly tube like structure is called epididymis. So this is called as epididymis. So the epididymis extending, so posterior side of each testes, so tightly narrow coil tube like structure. So this is epididymis is divides into three regions. So three region. So this is first part. So the first part is caput epidermis. Middle part is corpus epidermis, and the end part is caudal epidermis. Caudal. So first part is caput, corpus, caudal. Caput mean head. So that is first part. So corpus mean middle, and caudal mean end tail. So this is the structure of epidermis. Now function. So the epidermis function is number one. Sperm storage of sperms. So and another one is it is gives time mature the sperms. So it is look like a long and coil tube like structure. So it mean so the sperms are enter into the epidermis where stored sometimes in this time which is mature. So this is two functions. So this is about the epidermis. Epidermis is open into the vasa differentia. So next part is vasa differentia. So the vasa differentia definition is, so it is long tube like muscular structure. So this is originate from so caudal epidermis. So the function is receiving sperms from the caudal epidermis. So this long tube like structure, so it is extend through the inguinal canal and enter into the abdominal cavity, receiving seminal vessels, and also where here form a ductus ejaculatoriosus. So ejaculatory duct is formed. So how it is formed? So it is formed by fusing of vessels of seminal vessel, seminal gland, and also corresponding vasa differentia. So both are fused to form ductus ejaculatorius, ejaculatory duct. So these both ejaculatory duct fused form, so and extended to the prostate gland and into so urethra. So this is about the vasa differentia. Vasa differentia function is receiving sperm and transported to urethra. So this is about. Next one, urethra. So this is the urethra. So it is shared two functions. So this is terminal duct of urinary system and terminal duct of and reproductive system. So it is two functions, exit urine and exit sperms. So this urethra is originated from the below the urinary bladder and extending through the penis and finally open to outside of through urethral meatus. So this is about the urethra. And next function is penis. Next organ is penis. So this is external genitalia. Human sexual reproduction, this is the external genitalia, means it is also present outside of the body in the pelvic region. So this is also called as intromitted organs. Intromitted organs mean, so the sperms is introduced into the female vagina through the penis, and it is called intromitted organs. So the penis is formed by the three column tissues. So these three column tissues is, so this is the three column tissues, middle urethra, this is three column tissues. So the anterior column tissues is called corpora cavernosa. So the posterior column tissue is called corpora spongiosum. So this is the specialized tissue, so which is do erection, so during the coitus. So it is useful to insemination into the female vagina. So this is the three column tissues. Next, so the posterior side of penis, so a bulbous like structure is there. This is called as glans penis. This is called glans penis. So externally penis covered the skin, and here loose skin is present externally. So this is called as foreskin. So this is about the penis. External genitalia is complicated. So next, so the last part is accessory glands. So the human male reproductive system, three pairs of accessory glands is present. So number one, so one is seminal vesicle. So this is one seminal vesicle. So and another one prostate gland, and another one is bulbourethral glands. So these three pairs are present. So number one is seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle structure is a pair simple tubular so glands is called seminal vesicles, which is present below the urinary bladder. So the seminal vesicle secretions are contributed 60% of semen. So these seminal vesicle secretion contain so different components, which is proteins and another one citric acid and another one phosphorus. Another one prostaglandins, another one fructose. So this is components. So the fructose function is nourishment to the sperms, and the prostaglandins function is so use help of fertilization. So it is gives the way to fertilization of the egg. So this is the about the seminal vesicle. Next one, prostate glands. A pair prostate gland is present, so which is located below the urinary bladder. So these secretions also contributed 15 to 30% to the semen. So this is alkaline, and the function of prostate gland secretion is activated sperms and another one. So this is activated sperms and also nourishment of sperms. So this is about the prostate glands. And another one, bulbourethral glands. A pair bulbourethral gland which is present below the prostate glands. So also this is below the prostate glands. So the bulbourethral gland secretions are it is released before the ejaculating. So this is released and this function is lubricated the vagina during the coitus. So this is about the bulbourethral gland and also called as Cowper gland. So this is about the human male reproductive system.